Welcome back, everybody. R&V Family, what's going on? I'm your host, Tarius.
I'm D Morris.
And this is
Rhythm and Views.
Yeah, man. So I am a singer, songwriter, graphic designer, and entrepreneur and all that kind of stuff. I stepped on the stage with artists like John B, you know, Day 26. Yeah, Case
Donnell Jones. Case you didn't know.
And Michael McCary from Boys to Men. Just name a few.
I was about to say Michael Jackson.
I wish.
Well, listen, I'm D. Morris, singer, songwriter, producer. Mm-hmm. I've worked with Genuine. I've worked with Easy Mo B.
There it is.
And I work with me.
Mm, wow.
Yeah.
I don't know how you do that. And we busy. We got stuff popping off right here.
Is that me?
Nah, it's not. How you say right there? Who's that? D. Morris?
Nah, but
he
I work Easy Mo B, Genuine. And AZ and Mac 10.
That's a little bit about us. But yeah, this is the show. This is Rhythm and Views. And so we're going to run down the line, man. So y'all need to make sure you stay tuned all the way down to the end. Because you never know what you might miss,
that's
man.
That's right, baby.
You got to watch it. But before we do get started, man, what do they got to do?
You gotta.
Yeah, you gotta hit that subscribe button, man.
You gotta.
You gotta leave us a comment.
You gotta
spread the word, baby.
And you gotta
tell little JJ down the street.
That's
you know
right.
what
just
I mean?
Tap,
little JJ
tap,
ice
tap
fish.
All there. And then if you got any questions, just send them to rhythmandviewsshow@gmail.com.
Rhythmandviewsshow. How about that?
Oh yeah, you know
that's
what?
The remix,
that's the remix.
Yeah, rhythmandviewsshow@gmail.com.
What's wrong with me today, brother? Damn.
Oh no, but I don't know. What you sipping on over here with this Rhythm and Views mug?
It could be in the cup. Yeah.
I don't know. Or maybe you slipped on one of these brand new stickers and bumped your head. You know, I don't know. Merch is down below, people.
That's just right. Merch is down below. Check us out.
Yeah, man. But yeah, so we're going to run through the lineup. So on the video chat today, we got Terry Tobin. And
my
she's
friend.
Got a song. Yeah, it's Make It Beautiful. And so we're going to do that. And for the artist spotlight, we got Teyana Taylor. That's going to be a special one. My man's got a lot to say on the subject. And then for music notes, we got Angel Sessions.
Oh, yeah.
Ready to rock. She's ready to rock. So we're going to get into that. And we got the chime. And then, we're going
to
keep it going from there. So let's jump right in, man, into the first segment, which is the video chat.
Ha.
And today, with the video chat, we got Terry Tobin.
Yeah, my good friend.
And, what you know about the song Make It Beautiful, man?
You know what? I got to hear it again. I heard it once. I liked it a lot.
Okay.
I liked the video, too.
What's the backstory on that? Like, how did y'all meet and all that? You said that's a good friend of yours.
I met Terry Tobin through a good friend of mine, A.B. Money.
A.B. Money. Shout out to A.B. Money.
You know what I'm saying? And he asked me, A.B. Money, Easy Mo B, J.R., Rapping is Fundamental, Soul Survivor Click, which I'm a part of, the Soul Survivors for Life.
There you go.
And they brought it down to Connecticut. I was in the studio in Connecticut. And, I heard her sing, man. I was like, man, she got a voice, man.
Okay.
She really got a natural gift to sing, man. So
that's dope.
And we've been cool ever since. So she's going to be on our show.
That's dope. Okay, so we're going to do it. Matter of fact, I think this is the second time we've had her on.
Yeah, the first one.
We did the video.
Was, I forgot the name of the song.
That might have been Smile Again.
That might have been Smile Again. We were trying to figure out why she wasn't smiling.
Because she looked mad throughout the whole video.
Yeah,
so.
But I think she got redemption with this one.
Yeah, we're gonna have to do something, have a call in or something, or send an email, explain the video, break it down for us.
I'll give a buzz.
Okay, so let's jump right into this is the video chat with Terry Tobin, Make It Beautiful.
Bam.
So you are just looking too cute. Look at this dress. Girl, look at your hair. You're doing it. I'm not mad. You're looking good.
Girl, forget that. The question is, where have you been?
Where have you been?
Make up for all the bad
Okay, that was Terry Tobin with Make It Beautiful.
I like that.
You know what? He's got a lot to say. I'm going to let him go ahead. Take it away.
Terry.
Call me.
No, I'm just saying. No, I like this video for the fact that it had a very, very voluptuous tone to it.
Mm-hmm.
Very nice. The song was sensual. She captured the sensuality in the song. Oh, you think she did?
It has a voluptuous tone.
Oh, did I say voluptuous?
Right. Yeah, I think it did.
I mean, it had a curvy tone. It had a groovy tone. No, but all seriousness to the side.
All seriousness to the side. So that means now the clowning has begun.
The clowning must continue.
Yes.
But no. Terry told me you did your thing on this record. The song is great. Mm-hmm. The video was shot. It had like a BET sitcom smoky feel to it. I don't know if that makes sense.
Yeah, I get that.
Yeah, I mean, it had like that kind of. It looked good.
Yeah, it looks good. It looks real good.
And she had a very nice neckline.
Fact checker, true. Are you good back there? What are you trying to say, fact checker, true? She's giving me hand signals off. Are we good?
Just stop chewing the mint.
Okay, I'm eating a mint, y'all.
Oh, you chewing the mint?
Because you know what?
He liked the video too. That's
I like. Yeah. It was so hot and steamy, I had to cool down, with a nice icy mint. You know what
cool
I'm saying?
Iceberg mint.
There it is.
Iceberg Slim mint.
There it is.
But no, what you thought about the video, man?
I liked it, man. This is not the first time I've seen it. I've seen it a couple times, and
oh, okay.
At the production value, you know, coming from a videographer standpoint, the production value I felt was much better on this one than the first one.
Yeah. I agree.
The location that she chose, I don't know what club that was, but and I believe that most of the scenes, I think there was another scene too where she was with her man towards the end, but most of the shots were taken on that one location.
Mm-hmm.
But that's cool because what they did was they shot it in a way where you didn't feel like you was in the same location. They made it interesting, so I like that. Mm-hmm. There was one scene where she was standing there and people were behind her, the bar was behind her, the camera kind of came down.
Yeah, that
her.
Was dope.
Yeah, it looks professional. I like it. I definitely like the video.
Terry.
Let me think. If there was anything. Oh, you didn't even give it your score. Did you give it a score? No, you didn't.
I'm going to have to give it five music notes. I'm going to have to give it a 5.5 D.
Whoa. For D Marks. There you go.
For D Marks. 5.5 D.
Okay, 5.5. So you're in 3D. Okay.
Double D. I mean 5.5 score.
That's a nasty man.
Terry, you know I love you. Yeah, I'm just playing around. But I'm serious, too.
Only if you're going to do it.
Only if you're going to do it. 5.5. Okay. Terry, you did your thing.
Yeah. I really don't have any complaints about it. There was one thing in the intro. I thought the intro was a little weird for me because it was kind of like
she did
a little talking and then it kind of stretched out a little bit too long for me. Like, I felt like, okay, let's jump right into it.
Let's get into it.
So, yeah, but other than that, like I said, I thought the video was well done. I like the color purple she had going on in there. It was cool.
She was in color purple.
No, yeah. No, Whoopi Goldberg. But yeah, overall, I like the video. I'm gonna give that one 4.5. I'm gonna give that 4.5. Okay. I liked it. I enjoyed that video. I thought production value was good. I thought, you know, the cinematography was great. Alpha's was good. She definitely had a nice look throughout the video.
No, she did her thing. She looked very sensual.
Absolutely.
She looked happy. She looked, you know.
It's a good video.
Yeah, very nice.
Much better than the other one. I like this one a lot better.
You did your thing, Terry. You did your thing. And I want to see more videos of you.
Send your stuff in, Terry.
Send your stuff in.
Hit us up.
And
Send your video in, Terry.
Hey, True, why you laughing?
Send your video in. So that was Terry Tobin with Make It Beautiful. And we falling off the rails. And we're coming back.
She made it beautiful, man.
She made it real beautiful.
Yeah, Terry.
We appreciate that. Mm-hmm. So yeah, and if you're an artist out there and you have a video that you want to send in, how do you send it in, man?
rhythmandviewsshow@gmail.com. It's just that simple. That's
first, we're going to get it on for you.
Oh, get it on.
Because it's just that simple, baby. You already know, baby.
I feel like that's just a job turkey.
Job turkey, baby.
You dig?
You know, you dig? Come on, player.
I got my player hat on, too.
So that's
don't
how you
let me come out there and hurt nobody.
Watch out now. You might give him the sugar slim.
The sugar. We got to get that glove,
sugar
man.
Sugar slim.
It's almost 2021, too.
Shout out to Slap Turner.
So, Slap Turner, man. He make the gloves. I heard you got to go factory for
might have to.
Sugar slim
though.
Gloves. For the Lolo.
So now we're moving on to the next segment, which is the artist spotlight. And this is going to be a hot one because I know my man has been talking about this for a minute. Teyana Taylor's been going through some things.
Yes, she has.
He's got a lot to talk about.
Well, I got
a
couple things.
This is the artist spotlight.
I'm not going to drag it out.
Let's get into it.
Keep it simple. Teyana Taylor, she was born December 10th, mm-hmm. 1990. She's a Sagittarius.
There you go.
She's your sign.
Perfection.
And she was born in Harlem, New York, and she has two children. She's married.
Is that far from where you lived?
Well, my cousins live in Harlem. I was born and raised in Bed-Stuy, Brooklyn.
Okay.
I used to live in Harlem, too. I lived over there by Lenox.
Okay.
Not too far from the Apollo Theater.
Okay, that's dope.
Yeah, so you ever been to Harlem, man?
No, I have not been there. I've been to Times Square a few times.
Times Square is cool.
I usually kind of get in and get out. I don't really know anybody up there, so yeah.
Yeah.
I wish I had somebody show me.
But you know, right now, New York is totally different now. It's totally. So, but anyway, that's another story. Her spouse is Imani Shumpert. He's an NBA player. I'm sorry if I missed your name.
Oh, that's her husband, right? Yeah.
That's her husband.
Mm-hmm.
She's known for being, you know, an actress, a singer, choreographer. She's an excellent choreographer, mm-hmm. dancer, model. She's very good looking. And her albums to date, she had an album in 2014 called, I think it's Seven.
Mm-hmm.
Another album in 2018 called KTSE.
Okay.
which I don't know what that means.
KTSE.
KTSE.
I might put it on. I might put it on the screen.
And the album, which came out in 2020. Mm-hmm. Now that album that came out this year, 2020, mm-hmm. was supposed to be a big launch for her to, you know, get over the hump of doing everything herself.
Okay.
Being an, you know, an like artist.
So the label was supposed to help her?
The label was supposed to really come out for and push her project.
Okay.
And then COVID hit.
Oh, right.
And then that was, you know, COVID kind of put a lot of monkey wrenches and a lot of things across the board. And she's worked with Pharrell, Kanye West, mm-hmm. Fabulous, Jazzy Faye, mm-hmm. and what else? I said Pharrell, right? Star Trek Entertainment.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
She was signed to Kanye West, Good Music in 2012. But anyway, listen, what I wanted to say about her, I forgot. She was the choreographer for Beyonce's hit.
Oh, yeah. Yep.
Ring the Alarm.
Ring the Alarm, yep.
Ring the Alarm. Yep. That was the dope video, man.
Yeah.
Because that's the, no. Was that video with the one put a ring on it?
I don't think so.
Was that the same? So. Is this the same? True.
Ring the Alarm, I don't think that was something different.
It's something different?
Yeah.
If I'm not mistaken,
yeah. Because I'll be honest, I'm not a heavy Beyonce fan. Don't kill me.
Okay.
I'm not sure.
The Beehive, when you come sting, come get him.
Hey,
I know they vicious.
Much love to you. Just, you know.
No, don't sting him. That's my boy. But make a long story short, man. She just said she was retiring from music.
Mm-hmm.
And which is the reason why we wanted to have it.
Before we get into that, yep. I actually wanted to mention because and to be honest, like as far as like Teyana Taylor, I've heard her name, you know, a lot over the years, and I never really got familiar with her music. It might be something where I might have heard the tracks before, but not really known that was her or whatever. Once we started doing some research on her, I realized that, like you said, she's one that wears many hats. You know, she does a lot of stuff. She's singing, songwriting, you know, she directed videos. So
whole 9 yards, yeah.
Yeah, I could definitely relate to that. That touched a nerve in a positive way for me. You know what I mean? So I related to that. She goes by the name Spike Tay, I believe. Spike Tay.
Oh, Spike Tay.
A play off of, you know, Spike Lee.
Gotcha.
That's her AKA. You know, that's her director AKA name. And she did a couple of videos. I think one was Made It, Wake Up Love, 1-800 One Night, Love Me, Gonna Love Me remix.
Okay.
And so like I said, I wanted to mention that too. That, you know, I can relate to that. You know, so she's hella talented, man. She's hella talented.
She also won a BET award as director of the year.
Mm-hmm.
Best choreography, mm-hmm. as well. No, she didn't want for that. She won for best hip hop award director, mm-hmm. and best BET director of the year. So the point is with her, man, she does everything herself. Mm-hmm. And with her saying she's gonna retire, she says she was just frustrated with Def Jam, mm-hmm. because she was putting in 90% and they was putting only 10% in.
Right.
And she's on the label all these major artists, and she's not really get the attention.
She's got to be pushed to the back.
She's pushed to the back, and she wanted to, you know, bring her talent to the
forefront. She wanted to shine like everybody else.
So my thoughts on that was that, you know, here you got somebody that's a boss in her actions as far as doing the directing, doing the singing, doing the getting the music together, putting the players together.
Right.
You know, and then you with a company that was supposed to be doing that for you.
Mm-hmm.
They're not. So what I think what she should do, man, is get out of it, get out of that contract, because she's trying to get out of Def Jam.
Oh, she's okay. So she's still under contract.
But I don't think Def Jam is probably. I don't know, man. It's gonna be tricky. But if they ever let her go, I think she's probably gonna go independent. I'm almost certain she will.
Mm-hmm.
And I think she'll see more rewards going independent. What do you think?
Well, that's another thing that kind of touches touches my heart, because I've been in a situation where I was on a label. And that's why I said I can relate to her, man, because I do a lot of things too. You know, like I said, shoot my own videos and, you know, all that kind of stuff, write my songs, you know, arrange my songs, sing my songs. So, you know, when you get on a label and you expect to have that support, you know, because when you get on a label, you expect to, you're already doing it, you're already bringing this to the table.
Right.
You expect that label to kind of take that and embellish on it, make it even bigger.
That's your expectation.
Yeah, you know, you want that support. That's, you know, that's the machine behind you. They supposed to have that budget, you know. But if you feel like you're on a label and you still doing everything yourself and you're not even getting, you know, the credit you deserve, then if it, you know, you but feel that, like, I could do this on my own, I don't need you, you know?
That's what she was saying. She was like, she said, I've been doing all this, and then once I get a project off the ground, the label comes in and says, yeah, we got this artist, we doing this, we doing that. And she's sitting back saying, well, hold on, I did the work, I didn't do that.
Right, exactly.
So what the hell is going on? So if I'm doing 90% and I'm only getting a small piece of the pie, then I need to be off this shit.
Yeah, what do I need to be on the label for?
She's campaigning to get off. So I think Def Jam is probably trying to figure out how to get her off the label, keeping some of that money, and then letting her go do her own thing. But she's got the popularity now. She can do what she want to do once she gets off the label. Now, and use that popularity to fund her solo things.
Now, with the whole thing, is she talking about, she's talking about retiring, or is she talking about just doing it on her own? She's separated from the label,
Yeah, she's not talking about coming back in, but I'm just saying, from being an artist myself, as you are as well, I'm thinking that once you got that artistry in you, it ain't going
anywhere. Oh yeah, that never goes anywhere.
You know, that energy has to go somewhere else. It can't be just tied in.
Yeah.
So I'm thinking that she either gonna put it into fashion, she's gonna put it into film, but she's gotta get off of Def Jam to do that, to do, if she's gonna go back to being an artist.
Because they're gonna put like a lot of stipulations on whatever she does.
Yeah,
because she's
not, you know,
contract.
But you know what, she can let all that old music go. She's got the popularity. Why not just go and just do it somewhere
else?
Start fresh,
right? Yeah, she got the creativity.
People want to hear her records and everything. So
yeah,
just,
the fans were pretty upset about
they
that.
They were,
too,
yeah,
her,
yeah,
you know, it felt like she was quitting or whatever like that. But you know, sometimes, you know, from the fan perspective, you don't understand what goes on the inside. You know,
right?
They don't know all the, you know, all the stress that she's under. You know, and all the disappointment and heartbreak.
And
you know,
what,
not being
the,
able to do what she wants to do.
Right.
You know? So,
but the music industry has, you know, what it puts you through.
Yeah. Yeah, it's rigorous, man. I wanted to mention too that Fact Checker True, thanks, shout out to Fact Checker True. So over the Christmas holiday season, she blessed her fans Cash App with was it $500? You know, per not per fan, but she got on Twitter and said that she would do a Cash App a number of her fans, $500
each.
Oh,
well, then what's the information for the Cash App again?
Right. Well, I think Christmas is over now. I mean, the holiday season is still upon us.
She still might have that spirit.
Yeah.
She's giving more money than the stimulus checks.
Where she send it into? If she wants to send that money, where she
goes? Oh, the Rhythm Review Show.
At gmail.com.
And since it's three of
Sugar's
us,
on for us, baby.
I need you to send three checks. And we do a story about you, T. Come on, T. I know you can do it. I know we believe in you. But that's dope, man. That's dope.
She has said here, I want to give $500 each to a few people towards Christmas gifts. She said in a tweet, this ain't no sponsored. It's coming from my heart and straight from my account.
That's dope.
So
man,
I want to give to those who are
that's
rewarded.
That's dope. See that, you know, that's
really use it. Yeah.
That's dope, really, man. That's dope.
Yeah,
I mean, you think about
is.
It. I don't want to get political, but the, you know,
she's got that money.
She's making bank.
Exactly.
If you can do that, you give them $500 to people.
Yeah, that's what life's all about, man. You got to, you know, try to help other people, you know, because we all been there. You know, we got the point from where we was in the beginning. And then if you get to a point where you're successful, you're supposed to give back, you know?
Yeah, one way or the other.
I feel like that.
Yeah. That's how you get your blessings.
Exactly.
But shout-outs go to Teyana Taylor. We thank you so much. And whatever you do, keep on rising to the top. And again, rhythmandviewsshow@gmail.com.
For the Cash App?
For the Cash App.
We can use it, baby. Help us out.
You know what I'm saying? We need another latitude around another mic, perhaps, for Drew.
Yeah.
What do you think?
I'm a fan now, actually.
That's
our heart. Yeah.
Absolutely.
So, yeah. Much love to Teyana Taylor.
Yes.
So now we're going to move right on to the next segment, which is the music notes.
Yes, indeedy.
And today we have Angel Sessions, and she's ready to rock.
I'm ready to check
Shout
it out.
Shout out to Angel Sessions for that. And my man Rodney for that too as well. So we're gonna go ahead and get that started.
Is it hooked up?
Yep, here we go. And here we go.
So fine, let me feel something inside. I want you to know, speaking my heart to you, I gotta be honest with you. Every day, baby.
Ready to rock. That was Angel Sessions. Now, y'all might have heard me whispering to D Morris. I was wondering if there was, because we playing it through the mixer. I was wondering if there was an effect on there, because we hear like a little.
It's an echo.
Like an echo or something.
I think they was going too far with the 90s sound.
So I'm going to say that's the first thing that just immediately hit me was the little echo on the track.
I think that's what it was.
Yeah, I didn't. Yeah, I wasn't really feeling the echo part of it, but I'm going to let you go and take it away first.
Well,
brother.
First things first, shout out to Angel Sessions.
Shout out.
Thank you for sending your track.
Shout out to Rodney Cruz. That's a, I believe that's a management, or that might be the label. I think he's got the label. I think she's under his label, Rodney Cruz. Shout out.
Rodney Cruz, you too, sir. I think that the song was a good song. It's a good song. Mm-hmm. I think the song is a good song. The problem I had with it was... it wasn't the fact that it was going for a 90s feel, which I thought was excellent, but the production value was not. If I was rating the production value on a scale of 1 to 10, I'd get the production value maybe a 5.
You would get the production value a 5? So you liked it then?
No, I didn't like it.
Oh, so out of
out of
10. Okay, my bad, because I know we was doing 5 music notes.
Yeah, that's not our scale. This is another scale.
Okay.
I just created the scale.
Okay, there you go. Y'all heard it here first.
but no, the production value wasn't good. I didn't like it. But I understood what it was going for. I think if they made the mix better, and got the mix better, because the mix wasn't a great mix either. It wasn't a good mix because it sounded real echoey.
Mm-hmm. Like you said, like that echo, yeah.
And some of the choices of sounds I didn't necessarily like it. So on a scale of 1 to 5, I would give it a 2.45.
There it is. 2.45.
That's, I'm just
D
saying.
Mars scale.
But that doesn't mean that you can't send other tracks in. I'm just saying. Mm-hmm. This is just my critique.
Yeah.
I'm thinking that you have room to grow.
Mm-hmm. There it is.
You know what I mean? What do you say, sir?
Yeah, so, you know, I agree with a lot of things that you said. Like I said, right off the bat, that track with the echo on the track and the voice and stuff like that, I felt like that was a little too much. Another thing that I noticed right away is that it definitely sounds like, okay, how can I put this? If it was a track that came out for like today, then you know it's not really on that standard. But if this track came out in like 95 or 97, this is no disrespect. If it came out like 95, 97, I think it'd be out of here. It would have been
pretty cool. Yeah.
So that's that thing. But then you know that might be her thing. You know, because I haven't heard enough of her music in order to know that might be her thing where she's trying to, you know, capture that old school. But
that's dope though. That's
then
dope.
You could say too is that, you know, that's fine. But if you want to do some of that old school, kind of mix it with some little bit of relevance so that you can kind of
took the old elements and mix them with some new sound.
Yeah. 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 Yeah.
And then make it something old and new.
Yeah. 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 Because Uncle Charlie, man, he does that. Like
Uncle Charlie, Charlie Wilson, Charlie Wilson.
Absolutely, yeah.
But his production team that's working with Charlie,
something totally different.
It's top notch.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So,
but yeah, overall, I would say that like I said, it's kind of tough because okay, I like it as like an older track. Like if it was out of the 90s, like I said, I thought it was really good. But if it's going to survive in today's market, I feel personally that it would need some updating. It needs some work. Like you said, instrumentation.
Instrumentation. What do you think about the vocals?
The vocals. Thank you. I thought the vocals was good.
Yeah.
You know, for her style and everything like that.
It fit the record.
The vocals was good. You know, I thought the vocals was good.
It was just the production. The production was off.
Yeah, so
the mixing and the production, if that was tighter,
yeah,
it'd be dope.
So you know what, now I'm thinking about what you said as far as like production, yeah, Yeah. Actually, no. It's not even just that, because you know she could have had an updated track, but if she still sang it the same and still did the same some of the same licks and some of the things that she wrote, the way that she wrote it, the style that she wrote it in, you know, like backgrounds, harmonies, because even the backgrounds and the harmonies to me sounded like, you know, out of like, you know, 95 or 94 or something like that.
Yeah, it was totally, you know, in that
just
style.
The way she did that. Yeah, it was totally that
it's
style.
Like, it's
so,
like Christopher Williams. Yeah, got that vibe to it.
Yeah. So you know, one is going to have to compliment the other, but both was on that same. You know, the vocals was like that style, track was that style. So yeah, you know, so I would give it a three. Because I felt like it was a good song, but I felt like, you know, like there's room to grow. And yeah. You know, from my opinion, and like I said, if he was trying to, you know, for back in the day, it's great. But for today, I felt like you need to kind of bring some new elements into it, you know, for my personal taste.
Send some more stuff in the interview. Yeah.
But definitely, you know, she's definitely a great artist. Shout out to Rodney Cruz. He's a great dude.
Yeah, send some more stuff in.
You know, he's always supported me in my career. And I appreciate that. And I appreciate you for sending us Angel. And definitely, if you want to send us some more songs, I want to hear more. You know, because you may hit us with another song. We might feel totally different.
Right.
You know, so send us in some stuff, man. And if they want to send us some stuff, or any artists out there want to send us some stuff, how do they do it?
The rhythmandviewsshow@gmail.com.
Yeah, we'll put it on for you, baby. Because that simple.
We need you guys to subscribe, to like the channel, to hit the like button.
Thank you, brother. Yeah.
Subscribe, like, tell a friend about it. We're trying to get out some subscriptions up to 1,000 by next month.
Oh, shout out to Urban X. They trying to help us out with that too.
Yeah, they doing their thing.
Black Dot. Shout out. So that was a music note. So now let's jump right into the next segment, which is the chiming. Yeah.
Oh yeah.
Bam. We're gonna get the tassels eventually, y'all. Don't worry
about it. Yeah, I'm working on it.
We're gonna make it extra sparkly, you know.
We're gonna be velvet too, velvet.
There it is. Yeah. So this is the segment of the show where we take all your questions and we answer them and do the best we can, shoot them right back to you. And there it is. Fact check or true, what is the first question of the day?
All right, from Kittles, Cuddles 2.
Kittles and Cuddles. Kittles and the Cuddles.
Wow.
They got the Cuddles
and the Kittles. Cat groovy, baby.
Yeah, babe.
Clearly you will each have a unique experience with this.
Mm-hmm.
What's it feel like to perform live? Do you go through a process? Is it easy? Is it challenging?
He does it every single week. So yeah, you know,
well,
I do five times a week.
I mean,
shoot, if you did it five times a day, you wouldn't be sitting here right now. You'd be in a hospital laid up somewhere.
I'm talking about something else. I'm sorry. I get
the nasty man. Boom.
I couldn't resist, man. I don't do it five times a day.
Listen, the thoughts of D. Morris are not necessarily the thoughts of Rhythm of You Show. All right. So go ahead, brother.
But no. What was the question again?
How do you prep for a show? Like, how do you get
into the show?
What's it feel like to perform?
Well, I mean, like I said, I do about 5-6 shows a week, every week.
Crazy.
So for me, it's just a matter of preparing. Mm-hmm. Like, if you know you have a test in school, say you're in college and you study for a test and you've been studying every day,
mm-hmm.
and finally, so you're gonna still be a little nervous, mm-hmm. but you got more confidence because you prepared for the test. So it's like that with performing. Even though you might have butterflies, it helps to relieve some of those butterflies when you prepare.
Mm-hmm.
Do I still get nervous? Yeah, I get a little nervous, but I get nervous. No, I don't. I've passed that.
Mm-hmm. You've been doing it too long.
Yeah, mm-hmm. I get excited.
Mm-hmm.
I get excited before my gig.
Mm-hmm.
Now, if it's a different gig that I haven't done before, and it's some new material that I'm still working out,
mm-hmm.
I may get a little butterflies, but then I'm excited because I want to see what comes out of me. I like mm-hmm. to test myself.
Yeah, that's good.
And then I critique myself, and then I say, okay, I can do this better. Take this out, add that in. So,
mm-hmm.
so the main thing for me is just preparation.
Yeah.
You know.
My man said, one of my good friends, Steve Mercado. Shout out to him, man. He said that you ain't human if you don't get nervous. You know. So he said,
I ain't human. Man.
Even he's you superhuman. Yeah. Even the best. Even Michael Jackson gets nervous. Mariah Carey gets nervous. But as far as like myself, I'm more like, at the moment right now, more behind the scenes, so I'm gonna refer back to when I was in my group and doing some of my solo stuff. Like he said, like I feel like my strength comes from if I know I've rehearsed it, you know, then I feel prepped. And for me, that gives me the confidence to go out there and do what I got to do. Not saying that I might still not get nervous, you know, because like one of the shows that we did on the Christmas show, I told you
that
because it was live TV and live TV. Every time we did live TV, it always made me nervous because it's like, you know, like you get that one shot. There is no messing up. None of that. You know what I mean? But anyway, like I said, you know, I feel like preparation is what gives me the confidence, you know, because if I know I prepped for it and I know I prepared, I practiced as much as I could. You know, that's all you really can do at the end of the day is prep, you know, so.
Well, going back to what your man said about Michael Jackson, even Michael Jackson gets nervous. Mm-hmm. Okay, I gotta dispute that.
Dispute that. What you think?
Now, Michael was shy when it came to intimacy between one and one person.
Mm-hmm.
Like when he was doing the
like
whole
small,
Thriller.
Intimate.
When he was doing like Quincy Jones, she was recording Thriller.
Okay.
So Michael was writing Billie Jean and all that kind of stuff.
Mm-hmm.
And so Quincy said, and this is Quincy telling the story.
Mm-hmm.
He said, well, Michael, let me hear what you got for Billie, for, you know, for the song. Let me see what you wrote.
Mm-hmm.
So Michael said, well, you got to turn the lights off, turn around.
Right.
And I don't, you know, he was
nervous.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So somebody, but Michael said though, said, they asked him, when you do a show, you ever get nervous? Michael was like, no, I'm more excited.
Because
I want to see what I want to do. I'm excited.
I could definitely see that.
So, you know, because Michael.
He was more shy off stage, I think, than he was on stage.
Exactly. Because when he was on stage, he lived it. Because he practiced, like, his father put him through a, oh my God, it was ridiculous.
Yeah, we already know about that story. Yeah,
yeah. He whipped him into submission.
Yeah, exactly.
But even Barbara Streisand has said, yes, she gets
nervous. I mean, everybody's different.
Everybody's different, yeah.
Everybody's different, you know. Yeah. So, I mean, a little nerves is cool because it keeps you. But like my man Tim, I always quote him, Tim, the guy with the book.
Tim Grover. I was surprised you forgot. We always talk about Tim Grover.
Relentless is the book. Grover, Michael Jordan's coach, Kobe Bryant's coach. He said that when Michael Jordan, he would ask Michael Jordan before a game, Michael Jordan, what's going on? I got a little butterflies in my stomach, Michael Jordan would tell him.
Mm-hmm.
He said, well, cool, good. Just make sure you direct the butterflies.
Yeah, it's that energy. It's all about the energy.
You direct the butterflies.
Direct that energy to the goal. Yeah. Yeah. So hopefully we answered that. It was long-winded, but yeah.
Long-winded deal. Once again, I strike again.
Question number two.
All right.
That was a good one, though.
Tiffany Joy, 2008.
Mm-hmm.
What's your favorite song to perform and why? Like, does it mean something to you, or is it the vocal range or fun or?
Yeah, I'm gonna jump in first on that one. Over the summertime, my good friend D Morris, he invited me to come out to some of his shows and I performed my song. Hopefully, y'all check it out. Actually, I didn't even do a video for it yet. I started shooting a video. I need to finish it. But anyway, welcome to my world.
Welcome, you take my song, man. Welcome to.
I'm stealing his material, y'all, because I can just do that, you know. But
it's all good. You can buy it.
Yeah, the summertime song I have right now. I'm drawing a blank. Oh, my own material. How you like that?
Work that body.
It's a great song, man.
Yeah. So,
great song. Yeah.
But anyway,
very, 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 very good song.
I got my own damn title.
Matter of fact, let me just say something. That Work My Body. We did a show up in Bradenton.
Which one? Oh, was that on the beach?
At the coconut hut.
Yeah.
So he wasn't really coming to do the song. He was just coming, hey, can you play the song for the night?
Chill out. Yeah.
Of course, I'm gonna play because this is my dude.
Right.
So I said, well, come on, perform it. So he performed it, man, and the people went crazy. Like, the girls was dancing. They left, him and True left. And then they was asking me, where's Tarius? What happened to that guy that was singing the song?
Right.
I said, he left. He said, oh, he had a good song. So they really liked the song.
Yeah, I appreciate
they really
that, man.
Liked the song.
You know what? You being an artist, you can definitely relate to this. It's like, I feel like that song in particular is... like if I had like a big machine behind me, if I was on a label, like, you know, like Teyana, well, maybe not like Teyana Taylor because she ain't having her label. But if I was on a label and pushed that song, I feel like I'm confident in that song. That I think that would have been.
But with the right marketing budget behind
that,
it. But it's still not too late for that song to take off. It's just.
Yeah. Yeah, but
it's just a different way of doing it.
It's fun, and you know the reason why I like performing it because it's a nice little fun song. It's got a kind of like a tropical vibe, island vibe to it, and it's fun to perform. You know what I mean? So that would be mine. That would be my song.
My song would be. Probably She Likes to Move is one of my songs.
I like that one. Yeah. I like the up-tempo stuff.
Yeah, I get tired of saying it from time to time. People like it. They get on the dance floor.
Mm-hmm.
It's one of my songs. If you look up Dave Morris online, you'll see She Likes to Move. You can buy a copy of it.
And we might have actually played that. That's the intro, isn't it?
That's the intro music to the show.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
So,
I thought it had that good energy. So,
you know, it's got a kind of a Usher vibe to it.
She likes to move, baby.
She likes to move. So, that's the song that I like. Yeah. I like to see them dance. You know?
Mm-hmm. And you usually get a pretty good response with that one too.
Yeah, yeah.
You know what? Oh, for y'all artists out there, if you ever want to know, like, if you really want to test your song and see if it's good, just play it at a live event. However you can do it.
Strip club. No, I know it's
that's
quite,
actually
no.
Kind of, I've actually been. I played my stuff in strip club before, so yeah, that's actually true.
What's his name? The guy that's in Africa. What's his name?
To my Mowgli?
Not Mowgli.
Akon. Okay.
Akon said anytime. Sorry, Mowgli. Mowgli doing his thing.
He said, "What I have to do with this?
Keep me out of this strip club.
Keep me out of this strip
club. I'm thinking about my daughter and my father."
Blue. Shout out to Mowgli.
No, and I'm working out, so leave me alone. Akon. He said anytime he had a song he was putting out that he wanted to test the market with, mm-hmm. he would go to the strip club mm-hmm. and play it. And if the strippers like it, he knew he had something to deal with. Mm-hmm. He had something to work with.
Yeah.
So,
okay. Yeah. All right.
They, you know, they dance for a living. They shake their butt. You know.
Yeah. If they ain't feeling, they ain't gonna move.
They ain't gonna move. Slide down the pole. They ain't sliding. If they ain't sliding on that pole.
Hey. The music got to go.
You got to go. It's a dud, son.
All right, fact check or true.
All right.
Question number 3.
And wilding out 911.
Nick Cannon, that's the guy. My dude, Nick Cannon. Always coming through.
Whoever it is says, look, I'm following the Rhythm and Views DMT Insta page and all this hush-hush.
Oh, yeah.
It's your combined project, right?
It is.
When is y'all's project dropping?
Huh.
Next year.
In a couple days.
No.
We're going back and forth through tracks. So I just sent Tarius some tracks.
We might have to explain the whole process of putting the album together. So, you know, when these days,
I don't think we're going to do an album right now. Mm-hmm. I think what we should do is an EP. Mm-hmm. EP is like,
I mean, it's not really
songs.
Like a, yeah, it's more like a single driven market right now anyway.
Yeah, exactly. I mean? So we're going to put singles out.
But it's in
we're
the
going to go strip clubs and we're going to just drop them and see who dances on the pole.
Exactly.
And then we know we got
something. We might even videotape it if we're allowed to bring a camera or we sneak a camera in.
Exactly.
And show y'all.
You might just see a thong moving. Mm-hmm. But it's too one of our dresses.
It is what it is, baby. You
know? But no, we by next year, I'm thinking about February. Mm-hmm. I would like to have something by Valentine's Day, man. At least a song. Yeah, one song.
I like that. Yeah.
Valentine's
Day. We'll put it right here on the show.
Right on. It's just that simple.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly. But so, yeah, that's the answer to that. Fact check or true, do we have any more questions?
That's all we have for today.
Okay.
All
right. That's
all right. Well, that's good, time, man. You had a good time, too, brother, man.
Yeah, we're going to have to do this again next week.
Yeah. We got to do another show after this.
Yeah, we might have to do that. Yeah. Oh, and... hopefully y'all had a good holiday season and all that, you know, Christmas and, you know, New Year's and all that.
Yeah.
So shout out to y'all. Much love to y'all. Hopefully y'all enjoyed that Christmas special.
Did you know they did? Did you know the Christmas special has the most views?
No,
out
I
of
did
all
not,
our videos?
I didn't. I didn't.
The Christmas special has the most views out of all the videos we put out.
Okay. That's dope. That's
so
dope.
We want to thank you guys.
Everybody got into the holiday season.
No,
and
we got a lot
up.
Of views. I said, wait a minute. And it's significantly
different
it's
than
like,
the rest of
it's like it's 500 views or something like that for that one video.
Oh, okay. I haven't even looked at it just yet. I haven't looked at it yet. Yeah.
So we blowing up, son.
That's what's
we
up. That's
up.
What's up. Shout out to everybody who's supporting us right
Saint
now.
Nick did it for us, man.
Absolutely. You know that love is going around. Absolutely. Okay. So with that being said, brother.
On that note, don't forget to subscribe.
Yes. Subscribe.
Subscribe and subscribe.
There it is.
Hit the like button. Let somebody know about the show.
Tell a friend.
On that note, we'll catch you guys on the B-side.
Peace.
Na 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 na.